The more you're connected to people who are not connected with each other, the more likely you know people in different groups. So a consultant knows someone in this organization, someone in this organization, people in this organization, wherever I've worked or wherever I visited. Yeah? That network looks like a star pattern where you have lots of ties going out. There'd be a home base where everybody tends to know one another, but there's a lot of arms reaching out. The lack of connection between people at the end of these arms are called structural holes. They're holes in the social structure. And it isn't that they're insisted upon, it's just we're so busy, we don't have time to know everybody everywhere who's relevant to what we do. Yeah, there's a subset that we get to know. There's a lovely metaphor that a fellow at MIT worked up maybe 20 years ago, and it's called sticky information. As we do the same thing again and again, we get better at it, but we develop a style of doing it. That's the way we do it. Over there, they have a different style. Over there, they have another style, just depending on the people and who's brought together. That information gets really sticky because it's not written down anywhere. It's not going to just suddenly move to another place. And a person could come in and watch what you're doing, but you're using a language that you and your colleagues have developed to do this, and so it's not immediately obvious what the implications are, why you're doing it that way, etc. When information gets sticky, you can't ship it. You can't send a memo. People don't understand it. What these people who have the broad networks do is they clear a sticky information market. By breadth, timing, and arbitrage, they move information from this group over to this group in a way that creates value here, in a sense that it solves something that they wouldn't have seen otherwise. And what ends up happening is these people are paid much more than their peers, are promoted more quickly than their peers. I don't know how he found that, but that was fantastic. Yeah? And it isn't always, I've got a great idea. Often it is, how do I convince people to buy into this idea? And that means I've got to know how you think, I've got to know how he thinks, and I've got to be able to say, this is the idea, but from your perspective, it would look like this. From your perspective, it would look like this. And so you often hear these people who are called network brokers, they're brokering across different groups, you often hear network brokers saying, I think you're talking past each other. I think he means this and you mean this. Ah, well, why didn't he say so? You know, it's sticky information. There's just a wonderful market to be made in it.